Self-proclaimed fungi wranglers Megan McFarland and Adam Vicknair grow gourmet, medicinal, and regional mushrooms in Wimberley at Fallen Oak Mushrooms. They grew their horticultural roots at home and working in urban agriculture. In 2014, they incubated their mushroom business in modified backyard storage sheds.
And I think that anything that's you consider a passion, you know, that's what you have to do if you're driven to do what you love, is make it work for you financially, and that's what we're trying to do.
In 2015, that passion led them to 4 acres in Wimberley, where they grow enough to sell to discerning restaurants and at the Dripping Springs Farmers Market.
It's harsh, rocky land, but it suits our needs, and it had a house on it, a beautiful house. We sort of just fell in love with the house and the land all as one package and said, let's go for it. The community's lovely out here, you know, great people doing like-minded stuff, small-scale farms and whatnot.
So, why mushrooms?
We were really passionate about mycoremediation and mushrooms being used therapeutically, and just became really passionate about what mushrooms can do for us. And
definitely.
Also, they're delicious.
How do you grow mushrooms?
Getting all of the materials, that's where our week starts. So we gather hardwood sawdust from cabinet makers and other recycled sources, as well as coffee grounds from our local coffee shop, Sip on the Square. Everything is reclaimed, and the cool thing about growing mushrooms is you can take these waste streams, like agricultural waste streams or commercial waste streams, and turn it into gourmet food. We mix it, put it into autoclavable myco bags, and then steam pasteurize those for 12 hours. And that kills enough of competing microorganisms that give the mushrooms a chance to grow on the substrate.
Incubation starts on petri dishes in their lab-like building.
The only consideration with the lab is that it has to stay clean and it has to be air-conditioned, because that's where we incubate the mushroom bags before we actually fruit them. And they need to be incubated at like 75 to 80 degrees. We'll order a slant, which is basically a test tube that has a mushroom culture in it. And when I say culture, I'm referring to the mycelium, which is basically the roots of the mushroom. It's most of the organism, but it's what you don't see that's underground. So this tube will contain a tiny bit of this mycelium, and basically we take a section of that and put it on a petri dish, expand it from there, and then we have autoclaved, sterilized organic rye grain in jars. And once it's expanded on the petri dishes, we'll expand it into those jars, further expanding the mycelium. From there, we expand it up to sawdust bags, sterilized sawdust this time, without the coffee grounds. And that's what we call sawdust spawn. So one petri dish can make, say, 4 jars, which can make, say, 8 bags, which can make, you know, 100.
We allow mycelium to grow all the way through the substrate, and once it's fully captured, which means we see mycelium covering 100% of the sawdust, we take it into our fruiting rooms.
They're the rooms that actually grow the mushrooms themselves.
We do a technique whereby we push all the air out, poke holes in the bag, and then where we've poked holes, the mycelium senses high oxygen and it pushes the mushroom fruits out at that location. Then they're in the fruiting room for about another 10 days, and then we'll see the first mushrooms start to bloom. And that means that we're harvesting and checking on the fruiting rooms at least every day, mm-hmm. if not a couple times a day.
We grow 3 varieties of oyster right now, pink oyster, blue oyster, and phoenix oyster. And then we also do lion's mane that we try and keep around all the time, which is a really beautiful, frilly, toothed fungus. We're trying shiitake,
maitake. We do shimeji, white beech.
That's in the works right now.
We try to grow seasonally. Even though we grow indoors, it makes sense to grow cold weather species in the winter, so we can keep our energy costs low, and warm weather species in the summer.
The normal button mushrooms you buy in the store do have health benefits, but our mushrooms, our specialty, especially the oyster varieties that we grow, have more health benefits. They have a more complete amino acid profile, and they also have vitamin D, B vitamins, and a lot of other health benefits that the normal button mushrooms don't contain.
They also grow reishi mushrooms.
They basically fool your immune system into thinking that there's an invader, and that gives your immune system a workout. They also contain compounds that reduce inflammation, So instead of causing an autoimmune reaction, it just creates a whole, like a giant army of white blood cells that are right. ready to attack as soon as an invader actually enters the body. And they also have clinical evidence for their effect against different types of cancer that help lower blood pressure. So a whole host of benefits with reishi mushroom. It makes them really popular with the herbalists in our community as well as acupuncturists, and we mainly grow for them. There's a lot of different ways that you can cultivate.
This is our shiitake log operation. And what we've done is you take fresh logs from an oak tree. Using a special drill bit, you drill holes throughout the entire log. We packed them with a shiitake sawdust spawn and then sealed them in with paraffin wax. We inoculated these last spring, and we anticipate that they'll start fruiting probably December, January, as soon as the lows at night start dipping into the 40s. A few feet away, we started a mushroom bed, an outdoor bed, where we inoculated hardwood wood chips with Stropharia rugoso, or wine cap mushroom mycelium. And interestingly, they didn't like our bed so much, so they ate their way under the ground to this mulch pile about a yard away. And if you just pull back the surface, you can see the mycelium running through the mulch, and we expect this to start fruiting with mushrooms in about a month here.
So when we implanted the Stropharia mushroom bed, we layered it with cardboard, and as you can see, the mycelium from the Stropharia mushrooms has totally eaten through this cardboard, and that's this white stuff that you see here. So certain mushrooms are dung lovers, they like poop. Certain mushrooms are wood lovers, so they just prefer different foods. And the wood lovers have the enzymatic action to break down that wood, and sometimes they're even specific to certain species of wood.
Mycelium actually helps to feed the trees. It breaks down nutrients in the soil and feeds your plants in exchange for sugars from the plant.
The mycelium, this white substance inside of here, it's kind of thready, is holding all this sawdust together. If you break it up, it really kind of just disappears, but there's these microscopic little fibers that are keeping all this together, and that's the mycelium.
They will thrive in wet, decomposing, decaying conditions, typically. If you want to cultivate mushroom on a piece of property, let some of your hardwood that falls on the ground lay where it is, and that will actually be a host food for different types of fungi.
Garden mushrooms are signs of good soil health, but they could poison you. Never harvest wild mushrooms if you don't know what they are.
They say that they're old mushroom hunters and there are bold mushroom hunters, but there are no old, bold mushroom hunters.
That's right.
Spent sawdust bags head to the compost pile where mushrooms continue growing. Megan and Adam use it to build up new beds on rocky soil. Fallen oak mushrooms provide scrumptious fresh harvest at the Dripping Springs Farmers Market. Get Megan's weekly updates at fallenoakmushrooms.com.
Every Wednesday we bring an allotment of mushrooms to sell to the public. And then we also sell to restaurant clients.
It's a lot of work, so it's definitely a labor of love.